I'm not afraid of death. It's something that has to happen. That day will come and we have to be ready. And we really have to talk about it with our children so they know too that these things happen, that death will happen and we can't avoid it.
The Festival of the Dead is held over 2 days and two nights. The first part of it is a quiet affair dedicated to the children who have passed away. They call them the Little Angels. The second part is more spectacular. It pays homage to the people who died that year and to the ancestors in general. Some of it takes place in houses and some in the graveyards. Tonight, the dead will visit the living. It's the moment I've been waiting for since I got to Mexico. For now, I go back to see the fisherman I met the other day.
This is a typical Day of the Dead meal. In the morning, we make beans with cheese for the dead children, the little angels. But I make it with fish, with mojarra fish and green chili. And here, I'm making some mole. That's rice and chicken with tamales. I did have 10 children, but two of them have died. Now I've got 8.
I can well understand the importance of this feast for this family who have lost 2 children, but that's not rare in these parts. Death is much more present in their daily life than it is for me, a European. Downstairs, the other members of the family are just as busy. I'm not surprised to come across more of those cempasúchil flowers.
We need cempasúchil, plantain bananas, oranges, apples, candles, incense, candlesticks, and we need to prepare the main dish, too.
Candeleros, comida. Mucha gente dice que...
As for the water, a lot of people say the dead come from a long way away and that they've had a really long journey. When they arrive, they're thirsty and, well, everyone needs water. That's why we have all these things. For example, the bread's there for nourishment. The plantain banana is a dessert that everyone eats, like the oranges and apples. The corn cob represents the tortillas we eat every day. And the main dish, the fish, is what we generally eat here on the island. The candle symbolizes the light that shines on everyone's path. So everything has a meaning.
For the Festival of the Dead, it is the custom to lay out on the altar the deceased's favorite dish in memory of happy times at family meals.
No estamos seguros que las personas vienen, pero es algo que
Obviously, we're not sure if the dead really come to visit us, but it's something we've been told ever since we were little. So it's a belief that stays with us.
Cada año viene gente que no está aquí.
Every year, people come here from other parts of the country.
En otros estados. Y esa gente, aunque viven lejos.
Some even come from abroad to be with their families.
Y de allá vienen para reunirse como familia. Y eso, pues,
It's those reunions that make this such a joyous occasion.
Alegre, contento.
We're all happy to see each other.
Pues, se encuentra con los seres.
And we all wait together for the dead to arrive.
En otros estados. Y juntamente con ellos, pues nosotros.
Just being together and in harmony. For us, that's a good reason to be happy.
Los que ya han fallecido. Y ese es un motivo de alegría, de convivencia y de armonía también.
¿Usted vive aquí?
Sí. ¿Muy lejos?
Sí. ¿De qué lado?
Se va caminando. ¿Cuánto tiempo se hace?
Los ancestros purépechas.
It was the Purépecha ancestors who created this ritual, and it's different in every village.
De una manera diferente. Por ejemplo,
in Tsintsutsan, for instance, it's not like it is here. And in Iguatzio, it's something else again. And the Yaroquaro, too. In every community, they have a different way of celebrating the Day of the Dead.
Hay unos que van como familia.
At night, some people go together as a family to the tombs, husband, wife, and the children. For others, it's just the wife who goes, and her husband just comes with her for a bit and then goes, and his wife stays on. That's how it is. Or sometimes the husband stays and the wife doesn't. Only one or two people ever stay all night.
La muerte es.
Death is. I can't find the words to explain it. I see death as like a road that leads you to the ones who left this world before us.
Queridos que han partido de este mundo. Mucho más pronto que nosotros.
¿Cuál es tu rostro, llorona, que canta y canta una plegaria desde la oscuridad de su celo, como un moribundo que acaricia el vientre de su tumba? ¿Cuál es tu rostro, ánima, que mece en su rebozo al hombre su último sueño?
No, I'm not afraid of death. It's something that has to happen. That day will come and we have to be ready. And we really have to talk about it with our children so they know too that these things happen, that death will happen and we can't avoid it.
¿Cuál es tu rostro, Catrina, que canta y canta y perfuma de cempasúchil el camposanto los primeros días de noviembre? ¿Cuál es tu rostro, pelona, que corona de lágrimas su amor a nuestros vaciados cuerpos, si no hay más que infinito en el espejo? Thank you.